All right, so there's been a lot of really weird videos going around in 2021. So recently I sat down and just made a list of some of the weirdest ones that I've seen, and I thought they'd make a good video. And I figured we'll just breeze through them. Some of them are short, some of them are a little bit longer. But nothing can prepare you for how weird number 13 is with Buffalo Horns guy from the January 6th event. So before we jump in, quick disclaimer, this video is just for entertainment purposes only, and the people that appear in these video clips could easily be lying about what they're actually viewing and experiencing. So just keep that in mind as we go through these. And for obvious reasons, when selecting clips for this video, I decided to stay away from anything regarding the 17th letter of the alphabet, the global sickness, the shots, or any elections. So first weird video is the White House lights on a timer. And in January 2021, around the time of the election, or around the time of the inauguration day, people noticed the White House lights were turning off at night, and they were turning off, it seemed like, at the same time every night. So this first video is Richard Citizen journalist on Telegram, doing basically a countdown to the White House lights turning off.
Okay, guys, it's almost 11 o'clock here at the White House. And there's a 10 second countdown to 11, so we're gonna try to see if we can catch the light of the white lights going off. So let's see. Got it. Lights out.
Really weird stuff. So I don't know how long this was going on for. I didn't really keep up with it, but I did see something around October 21 that he said something along the lines of the lights seem to be staying on later tonight. I caught them turning off around 1 o'clock a.m. So maybe they're still on a timer and they keep turning off around 11. I don't really know. But also in early 2021, shortly after Inauguration Day, people started to notice that there were some odd differences between Trump's White House and Joe Biden's White House. So, for instance, some of the pictures going around in early 2021 was the carpet. Donald Trump's carpet is like gold and red, and Joe Biden's carpet was dark blue with like red flowers and green vines trimmed around the dark blue carpet. And people noticed that Joe Biden's carpet was very similar to a movie set, Castle Rock Studios' American President. And in addition to the very coincidental, very similar carpet to the movie studio, they noticed things like a gap in his wall during one of his TV broadcasts. And around October-ish 2021, the mainstream media started reporting on him actually being on a movie studio. So here's a video clip from the Washington Post of Joe Biden. He'll wrap up speaking, and then the cameras will zoom out, and you'll see just around the edge of the video, you'll see the studio lights above. And yeah, so here's that video.
How would you define success this week, legislatively? How would you define success legislatively by the end of this week?
Well, it may not be by the end of the week. I hope it's by the end of the week. But as long as we're still alive, we got three things to do: the debt ceiling, the continuing resolution, and the two pieces of legislation. If we do that, the country's going to be in great shape. Thank
What's
you.
Your message to Democrats as you have these calls? What's your message to Democrats, Mr. President? Mr. President, will you go to the border?
In addition to Washington Post, here's a Breitbart article about the exact same thing. Here's the Breitbart article, Breitbart.com. And it says that the White House creates illusionary White House set for Joe Biden events. You can see the studio lights. It's very clearly not authentic. But at the bottom, they say it remains unclear why the White House believes it's easier to create a fake White House set across the street instead of broadcasting from the actual White House building. And the White House did not respond to a request for comment about the video set from Breitbart News. So, Fox News actually picked up on this too. Here's the Tucker Carlson video from Fox News talking about the same thing. And he actually gets a response as to why he chooses to be on a movie studio across the street from the actual White House. So here's that video.
Take a look at the latest example. These are pictures of a fake White House set that the Biden administration has for some reason constructed across the street from the actual White House. It's in an auditorium at the Eisenhower Executive Office Building. Why go to the trouble? They already have a White House. Well, Stephen Miller spent the last 4 years in the White House as an advisor to Trump, and here's his explanation for it, because he would know. Quote, the reason Biden uses this bizarre virtual set for televised meetings and not an actual room like the East Room, the Cabinet, the Oval, the Roosevelt Sit Room, etc. There are a lot of rooms. The reason he does this is because it allows him to read a script directly from a face-on monitor and without teleprompter glass that can be seen on camera. Oh. Now, we can't verify that that's true, but it certainly sounds right. Joe Biden can't speak from the Oval Office because he's not sure what to say, so he has to read it all here.
Yeah, so maybe that's the reason. Maybe it's because of the teleprompter. But I did see pictures or videos that Kamala Harris also uses that same studio. And I didn't think she had problems with needing like a teleprompter and stuff. So I don't know. It's just weird. It's on the weird videos list 2021. Number three is the green screen videos. So it appears as though Joe Biden has been using green screens all year in addition to his movie studio. The first one, I mean, it's not just using green screens. It's at weird times. Like this first video, he walks up to some cameras and they say, any plans to travel to the southern border, sir? And his response is not at the moment, which it's such a short interaction. You could just film this authentically. I don't know why you would use a green screen for this, but it appears as though if you watch his leg is doing like a weird, like his pants are kind of glitching around the edges as if he's green screened. His hand, when he puts his hands up in front of him, his hand looks like a CGI layering glitch over top of the microphones. It's just really bizarre. Here's that first video.
Not at the moment. Not at the moment.
In addition to that video, I also have this like fact check article. So this is from Newsweek. They're talking about that exact green screen video, which they claim is not a green screen. But they mention, you know, however, others have shared a clip of the exchange from a different angle, which shows Joe Biden clearly in front of the reporters. So they're basically saying, if you would just watch the video from the second angle, that would clear things up. Well, I have that video from the second angle, and I think it's still just as weird. So here's from the second angle. You'll see it appears he's in front of the cameras, but again, his hand does that weird layering thing on top of the microphones. So here's that video.
Mr. President, do you have any plans to travel to the southern border, sir?
Not at the moment.
Border, sir?
Not at the moment.
Weird. Here's another video where it appears as though he's just walking through the White House, and the top of his head is like disappearing as he walks through this room. So weird. It would be much easier to just film him actually walking through a room. And this last one I couldn't find, but it was really good. He was just walking through like a grassy field. And instead of his shadow being parallel with the ground, like when the sun's overhead, your shadow's being cast on the ground, it's parallel with the ground. His shadow was vertical with his body, like a couple feet behind him, as if he was walking in front of a green screen and his shadow was on a wall that's parallel with his body. I couldn't find that one. I really wanted to show that one, but I'm sorry. Number four actually comes from the Kyle Rittenhouse trial. So some people noticed that there's a guy in the background and his foot just disappears to the floor at one point. The first video I'm going to show you is kind of like the conspiracy people online that were sharing that they think the whole thing's fake, which that's not what I'm suggesting. But here's a video showing what one group of people was saying happened at the trials.
Tell me this dude's foot didn't just disappear on the Rittenhouse trial. Gone. Plus the audience isn't hardly moving at all. It looks like a recording on loop. Like they're barely moving. They all look dead. And then I see this dude's foot disappear. Here it is again. That's a green screen, bro. Here's the video slowed down. It looks like there's something blocking his foot. This is all a circus. It's just meant to distract you. You can't believe anything you hear anymore, man.
So after that video, I actually went and I found the clean version from NBC.
And you'd only started working at the Recplex on August 14th, correct?
I believe I got hired before that, but I was on vacation on August 14th, so I couldn't...
It could be a couple things going on. You know, it could be a green screen. But there's this phenomenon where sometimes when certain pixels on a screen haven't refreshed in a while, and then you have movement where there hasn't been movement for a while, as it refreshes it, you get this weird artifacting, glitchy stuff. It could be that. It could just be that no one had walked on that part of the floor for a while. The video just had a hard time putting his foot there. I don't know, but it was just so clean. It's really weird. So it definitely belongs on this list. Number five is the FBI building. A lot of people were talking about weird stuff happening at the FBI building this year. And Richard Citizen journalist again, you know, he actually showed up. And here's his quick video of him just assessing what it looks like.
Hey guys, it's 5:25 on June 14th. Just want to show you here. This is the FBI building. And it's completely closed. No one's in there. In fact, it's even walled off. Can't even get inside. So that's what the FBI building looks like here in Washington, guys. What time is it? 5:26 p.m. on the 14th.
Very strange. You know, I never heard back if that was, you know, if they were saying they were moving buildings or if they were under construction or pest control. I never got an answer on that, but it's just one of those things. Number six is very strange. Colin Powell passed away recently, and at his funeral, the song that they played was Dancing Queen. So if you remember that song, Dancing Queen, from ABBA, here's them playing Dancing Queen at Colin Powell's funeral. It's such a recognizable song, and it just doesn't seem like the appropriate song for the event.
Thank you.
weird stuff. So after watching that video, I went back and checked out John McCain's funeral, and I checked out Bush Sr.'s funerals to see what kind of music they played at those. One of them had like a church hymn at their funeral. The other one had, I can't remember what the song was. I didn't recognize it, but it was either like a church hymn or it was like a patriotic song. It just, both of those funerals, McCain and Bush Sr., their music choice seemed very appropriate for the occasion. But Dancing Queen at Colin Powell's funeral was just one of those weird, weird videos from 2021. Number 7 is the presidential seal blurred twice. So this first video is from Joe Biden's official account at Joe Biden. And you'll notice, we'll let it start over. The presidential seal is blurred, and the blur is tracking with the seal as if they're blurring out the seal. And some people are saying, well, it's because it's his personal account and not the presidential account, so they blurred out the seal. But these are also presidential seals behind him on this flag. I don't know why you would have to blur out this one and not these ones. It's just strange. Here's another one that came out recently, and this is actually on Kamala Harris's Twitter account. And again, here's that blurred presidential seal. And Tim Pool reads the news like 24/7. He broadcasts like 8 hours a day or something. You know, he's got like 3 YouTube channels. And even he was unfamiliar with this. He said, is there an official reason to blur the seal? And again, maybe it's because it's her personal account, not her office account, but I don't know. It's just one of those weird things from 2021. Maybe there's a history of them doing this with other presidents, but it seems like it caught a lot of people off guard. So number 8 is very strange. Here's just a series of videos of people claiming that their local Walmart has been converted into like a military base or like a FEMA camp. You'll see military trucks at their Walmarts, that the inside has basically been gutted, just empty, and really weird. Here's that video.
At 10, a Tulsa Walmart that's been closed for nearly 3 months now is apparently still open. Jonathan McCall is reporting live for us with the video and details you'll see first tonight on Fox 23 News.
Well, since the store closed back in April, Clay, many people have been wondering exactly what's been going on inside the walls here. Tonight, we're getting some answers in the form of a video featuring 2 Tulsa police officers.
We told you then the store was 1 of 5 across the country closed abruptly. Walmart officials say it was to fix plumbing issues. Rumors, though, have run rampant since then that the store would be torn down or even used as part of a government operation. 2 Tulsa police officers are spilling secrets about what's really happening inside.
Man, they're gutting the whole thing.
This nearly 7-minute video shot by Brian Moore shows Tulsa officers Billy Burson and Daryl Ross chatting about everything from good cops, store security, and even more. Moore came across the duo while using his drone.
And we did reach out to Walmart officials today to try and get their comment on this video and whether or not how soon these doors will be open, but so far we have not heard back from them as of now.
This is our Walmart here in Fernley, Nevada. Military trucks and all these containers here. Welcome to Jade Helm Walmart.
The military says it's just training soldiers for the realities of war. Critics say the Army is preparing for modern-day martial law.
Reporting from the Springdale Walmart, or the closed-down Walmart in Ohio. I want people to notice I'm on the backside of the compound, and this wire runs a lot farther than just the old Walmart. It wraps all the way up around David's Bridal. Reporting from the Springdale, Ohio Walmart with the barbed wire on top of it.
This is their little complex. The sun's in the way. Why in the hell does Walmart Supercenter need that? See the Walmart trucks? See, it's like military style entrance, kind of like a FEMA camp.
All these FEMA trucks. FEMA everywhere. Took them 2 years to set all this up. Used to be a Walmart.
I'm at the neighborhood Walmart in San Jose, California. And this is what it has become. I did not want to believe it, but it's happening. Does this look like your friendly neighborhood Walmart to you? No. Anyone who knows anything about jail or anything about that knows what this is. That is a holding area. Oh, I'm not allowed to go past this line, actually, because the security guard told me if I do, it links up to the San Jose Police Department and they will come here and arrest me. That's kind of weird for a Walmart that's not in use anymore.
The Walmart in Medford, Oregon. I've been real intrigued by the idea that Walmart might become the processing center for martial law when FEMA camps start up. So I just wanted to show you guys what I found. It's kind of disturbing. Walmart has, you know, I try to stay away from Walmart as much as I can, but Walmart has the biggest, most, like, gnarly security system you have ever seen. So, you know, cameras everywhere. I've never seen surveillance, like, at Walmart before. So look what we have over here. Humvees, tanks. Really confused as to kind of what's, I mean, I guess I'm not confused because that's exactly what's going on, but it's all right behind Walmart. Yeah, look at these tanks, man. Not tanks, but just army gear. See all that? So they're setting up for something. We don't know what it is or when it's coming, but we know it's going to involve Walmart.
So after I saw these videos going around, that video that you just saw was like a 20-minute montage that I trimmed down to like 6 minutes. There were a couple different versions of that going around this year. If it makes you feel any better, I don't think those videos were recorded in 2021. From what I could tell online, it sounds like that stuff has kind of been going on for a couple years. And even that one guy in the video said it's taken them like 2 years to like convert this Walmart into whatever facility it's become. But just weird. Maybe it's a training exercise. I don't know if a training exercise that would require them to put military trucks at a Walmart and like take out all the products from the inside. It's just really strange stuff. But anyways, number 9, Mitch McConnell Masonic hand sign video. So earlier this year, Mitch McConnell was speaking, I think on like the Senate floor, and him and the guy behind him, they keep doing like this hand sign back and forth. You'll see what the hand sign is, and it's just one of those signs that like the Freemasons make at each other, a not-so-secret secret society, but it just seemed very obvious, and it's just a weird time for them to be doing hand signs, but here's that video.
Whether Congress should overrule the voters and overturn a presidential election. I've served 36 years in the Senate. Justify a radical break when the doubt itself was incited without any evidence. The Constitution gives us here in Congress a limited role. We cannot simply declare ourselves a national board of elections on steroids.
And then kind of along the same lines, number 10 is a Masonic handshake video. When normal people shake hands, you know, we fully embrace the other person's hand with our hand. We don't just grab their fingers. But if you're paying close attention, you can catch a lot of these, like, politicians. When they shake hands, they don't do a normal handshake. To somebody not really paying attention, it'll look like a normal handshake. But they basically, like, grab each other's fingers. And here's just one example of a video of what that looks like when you can start paying attention to how these people greet each other. Just really weird. So, number 11 is a short video. This is a soldier who just gotten out of a retirement ceremony for somebody. And he describes a letter that they received from the President of the United States. So here's that video.
Hey, TikTok, what's going on? So as you can see, I'm in my uniform. And I just got done attending a retirement ceremony for a guy I worked with for a number of years. This gentleman just received a letter of appreciation signed by the United States President, Donald J. Trump. I shit you not, that's exactly what it said on the citation. They read the letter of appreciation, and it said, signed, President of the United States, Donald J. Trump. I don't know what the hell's going on. I've attended literally dozens of retirement ceremonies, and those that receive a letter of appreciation is always signed by the current president. I'm not trying to add fuel to any conspiracy fire. I'm just telling you what I witnessed firsthand. There were a number of people there. Everyone, when that was read out loud, were looking around as confused as I am. If it is what it is, that's awesome.
Very strange. I'm not implying that there's anything more to this, but even him in the video, he's saying it's just a very strange thing that happened, which meets our criteria for belonging on the list. Number 12 is black lights around cities in the United States. So it seems like various cities in the United States are converting from, like, the normal soft white, soft yellow street lights to just these weird purple lights. And again, here's Richard Citizen Journalist just driving through a parking lot full of these purple lights. Here's that first video.
Okay, guys, I'm in North Charleston here, and I just driving past this whole shopping center. If you can see, it's all lit up with these strange colored lights. Not sure exactly what road I'm on right now, but I'm near, not far off from the C-17 military base in North Charleston. You can see these lights, and they're different than these lights you can see right there. So this whole parking lot's got these weird purplish looking lights. So anyway, this is what it looks like. Crazy. Okay, guys, I don't know. I've seen all this stuff on black lights, and I don't know if it comes through here. As I'm looking at this, these lights are all purple and they're in this parking lot. They're new LED lights. I don't know if you can get like a piece of paper or something that'll show it well. Let's see, I have a white shirt on here. Cool, so I'll show you. So, I don't know. That's a white shirt. It doesn't really glow, but it's a weird purple light. It looks like a black light. And it is 9 o'clock on September 3rd. This is North Charleston. It's just a parking lot. And all these lights in this parking lot are this weird glowing purple color. I don't know if it comes to the camera or not, but they all definitely look weird. Driving down the street, like, this is a purple light here, and like this is a normal light here. So maybe you can see the difference. So this is like a normal white light. And then over here, these are these strange, I mean, it's like a purple, it's like a black purple light. That's what it looks like. And all those are the same over there too. sorry if that comes through, but we're just driving to Florida and saw these strange lights and thought we'd show you because I've seen some of this recently. So here's an example of it in North Charleston.
Really weird. And the second video I have here, it appears to be a police officer. The guy's got a badge on. He's got like, it appears like a walkie-talkie and maybe like a bulletproof vest. He seems like a police officer. Here he is. He gets out of his car and he kind of looks at these same weird purple lights.
Hey, TikTok. So tonight I made an interesting discovery. Driving south on the 405 from Long Beach. I'm over here in Seal Beach by the power plant and I noticed these. It's the black lights. New lamppost that they've been putting in. And I've been seeing a lot of people talking on TikTok about these. It's definitely something new. I've never seen this before. As far as visibility goes, I can't understand why they would switch from the regular street lamps to this. I mean, you're losing about 80% of your light. So, seems weird to me. I don't know about y'all. And it's a big open parking lot where this is at. You can easily set up a nice little camp here. Tell me what you think.
And then, to be honest with you, nothing can prepare you for number 13. This is Buffalo Horns guy from the January 6th event. Very iconic person that showed up that day. I watched two videos on this guy. One of them I saw early January 2021, like shortly after the January 6th event. I saw one of the weirdest videos I've ever seen, and it's Buffalo Horns guy from before the January 6th event. One of his videos that I watched before this was from December 2020, it looks like. The other one was from January 1st. And even in this video you're about to watch, he mentions that he's been going to protests dressed in his like shaman hat. I don't remember what he calls it, but it's like that buffalo horns hat. And I mean, he gets into some weird topics. He talks about being in the Navy, first of all. He talks about out-of-body experiences and like walking on the sun. And it is so strange. It's like an hour and a half long, and I trimmed it down to probably 5 or 10 minutes, but I hope you enjoy it. It's very strange. Here's Buffalo Horns guy saying some of the weirdest stuff you'll probably ever hear.
What is up, everybody? I am Admiral Angeli, aka Yellowstone Wolf, and in this video, you guys, I'm going to be detailing exactly how it is that I got involved in the Super Soldier program, how long ago this started, how I was recruited, why, how it is that this kind of stuff works, because I'm definitely not the only Super Soldier that we have. But I am, as far as I know, the only super soldier that's allowed to come forward in this way. So if you can understand the story that I'm about to tell you, if you can kind of understand what happened to me, then you can understand what has happened to so many other people that are on this planet that are a part of this super soldier program and how exactly it is that one would get recruited into this, why they would get recruited into this, and the types of abilities that a super soldier has, you know, the quote-unquote superpowers that a super soldier has. So I hope you enjoy this video. I'm going to try to make it brief, but it may get kind of in-depth and maybe a little bit long. Like I said, I'm going to try to keep it brief, though. So where would a super soldier come from? Why does a super soldier get made? Where does this, you know, there's so many questions. Well, to start, let's start with the idea that in many cases, these super soldiers that are in these special access programs that are like basically off-budget, black-budget programs, these individuals are actually chosen for this task because of abilities that they have that are already like kind of given to them, or it's part of their lineage or part of their abilities naturally to have quote unquote enhanced psychic abilities. What we were talking about is people that are coming from different dimensions or different frequencies of vibration. In most cases with the super soldiers, for the most part, not all, we'll get to that in a little bit. We're talking about beings that come from a different dimension. In my case, we're just going to talk about my case in particular. Okay, in my case, I come from an extremely high frequency dimension of light, love, peace, and harmony, like an angelic dimension that I actually remember where I came from. But we'll get into that in a little bit. These individuals act like a statistical anomaly in the dimensions of space and time, and they act like a dispensation of a certain type of energy frequency within the all the universe, the multiverse as a whole, and they end up affecting the timelines. Okay, they end up affecting which timeline the planet moves to and toward. So with that said, that's where this whole idea of supervillains and superheroes comes from in the comic book world. Jack Kirby was actually a CIA agent, and comic books were soft disclosure. Whether or not you believe me, I understand this may create a cognitive dissonance for you. I understand that. Just trust me when I say that everything I'm about to tell you is true. Everything I'm about to tell you is real. This is all declassified at this point. And it's being brought to you in a way that hopefully you will enjoy, a way that you will believe, and a way that will give you all the affirmation that you need to know that the good guys, patriots, are in control. Know that I've been working hand in glove, as I and many other super soldiers have been for quite some time, against evil interdimensional forces. And we are fighting for life, we are fighting for good, we are at war. So because I haven't signed any non-disclosure agreements, but because I have all these above top secret clearances, because I've been a part of the super soldier program for quite some time, and because I'm a five-star admiral, I'm able to release all of this information to the public without any negative legal ramifications, which is not something that can be said for my colleagues. So what was my type of military service? Well, my type of military service was regarding the use of, one, plant medicines, two, the use of yogic shamanic techniques regarding the awakening of the kundalini energy and the opening of the third eye, and three, the harmonic balancing of the chakras and the resonance patterns within the spirit or the soul, and doing this again and again and again, reaching higher and higher states of consciousness that go beyond the physical body. Now, because I have developed my kundalini awakening and my chakras into these higher dimensional levels, I'm actually able to affect the quantum hologram, which is based off of all these invisible frequencies of light, much more drastically than, say, the quote-unquote average person. Just like all the other super soldiers are also able to affect the quantum hologram in this same way. And then around 13 years old, I had a experience with a friend of mine where I got really high, so high that I had an out-of-body experience where I actually realized that I was my soul, that I was this field of energy as opposed to my physical body. And I saw everything around me as though it was alien, as though I was on an alien world. My friend looked like an alien. His dog looked like an alien. My hands, I looked like an alien. The whole planet looked alien. It looked like I was seeing everything for the first time. I got out of the Navy. I started using my medicine again, the stuff I found while I was in the Navy. I started doing things like breathing techniques, shamanic techniques. I started doing things like yoga or Tai Chi or something along those lines. And I began to raise my frequency. And eventually it got to a point to where I raised my frequency so high that I realized that things like the Earth and the Sun and the galaxy or the black hole at the center of the galaxy were like harmonic octaves or consciousness anchors that I could like branch to with my awareness, okay, with my electromagnetic field that surrounded my body. So then I began to use these shamanic breathing techniques and yada, yada, yada to actually fly to the sun. And I have walked across the surface of the sun. I have seen events that are so tiny, so fast, that they could hardly be said to have occurred at all. And so I started to write book. I started to do like protests where I would go out in this get up here with my war bonnet and my staff, and on my staff I had a sign that said, you know, where will we be 7 generations from now, which is actually a Native American thing where they say we don't do anything unless we think of 7 generations ahead of ourselves. How would this affect 7 generations ahead of ourselves? So I'm going to get this extremely, extremely high frequency, and then I'm going to try something, and we're going to see what happens. And if it works, then cool, and if it doesn't, well, worth the shot, right? So what I did is I got in a really, really deep trance state, and in this mantra, I flew to the sun, and I like pulled some levers, I, you know, pushed some buttons, and basically I changed the
quantum entanglement of the entire solar system by doing this, by creating and changing, basically by putting all this stuff together and then creating a feeling within myself that understood all these things that was in the sun based off of, you know, the interconnection of everything and all the harmonics and all that stuff. So I flew to the sun. I changed my vibe. I ended up using the sun almost like a weapon and sending off a massive solar flare that took out all of the craft, all the negative ET craft, all these Satanists and their anti-gravity mind control type craft, which you have to watch my other videos to know what I'm talking about. And take all of those things out. And in the process, I also kept safe all of the aircraft that I knew were not the enemy, that I knew were our own, okay? And it is this this range in ability of expansion or contraction of my consciousness that gives me the ability to affect the quantum hologram through non-local entanglement, alter the timelines.
So weird. So I appreciate you watching this video. A lot of this stuff is kind of strange. I'll try to link the sources below. I can't link all of them because especially the Telegram stuff, I don't really know how to do a link to like a Telegram thing. But I appreciate you watching. Thank you.